Good evening. Congratulations to coach of Ritas for the win. We know will be tough game, and I am not afraid to take responsibility. I mean, because I couldn't prepare my team to act, you know, on the way what we expect from them. You know, I couldn't motivate them, even if I believe down myself that they know this is derby, you know. But still, we really show something which is not acceptable first half. And like I said, it's my fault. I'm not afraid. And now I know that. That I need to act different, and that's it. Second half was better, huh? But we didn't lose because of this defensive rebound in the end. We lose before, you know? And it's not big philosophy on this.
Sveikinu ryto trenerį su pergale. Žinojau, kad tai bus sunkios rungtynės, nebijau prisimti atsakomybės, nes nepavyko priversti žaidėjų žaisti taip, kaip iš jų norime. Galvojau prieš rungtynės, kad žaidėjai žino, kas yra šis derbis, tačiau ypač pirmoje pusėje nieko nepavyko nuveikti, tai nebijau prisimti atsakomybės dėl šito. Žinau, kad ateityje turėsiu elgtis kitaip. Antra rungtynė pusė buvo šiek tiek geresnė, tačiau pergalė ar pralaimėjimą lėmė ne atkovoti kamuoliai pabaigoje, bet pirma rungtynė pusė.
Coach, you said that you didn't motivate team enough for this before this game. Also, Marek Blažević during the halftime also said that team doesn't show enough motivation. Could it be that your players didn't have enough motivation before this game?
Could be.
Could it be that your team didn't have enough motivation before this game?
Look, I cannot go in the players' head. You know, it's derby. You know, you will for sure. You know, it's always easy to find excuse. No matter what, you know, we lose against Alba. They try. I cannot say they don't try. But who cares? You know, I say many times. Who cares? Who play for Žalgiris? How many injuries we have? Nobody don't care. Žalgiris must win every game. If they don't win, we must fight every game. Until the last minutes, you know, this how it's the picture of Žalgiris, I mean. And still some players, they don't understand where they are, you know. This is the main point. Definitely to beat Ritas, you know, motivate, we know. I mean, Ritas, first of all, is very good team, strong physically, you know, they're motivated. We need, you know, 10 players, and for sure, you know, because we have now a little bit bigger roster, you know, some of the players, I believe they think maybe, you know, even they can, I mean, you know, maybe I will. Because before in Elka, in LKL League, some players, they rest, you know, because of the EuroLeague. But I also say this to the players before the game, you know, this is like EuroLeague game, you cannot, don't calculate, we have enough time to rest until Friday. We need each of them and to give maximum, but obviously, you know, this was not, obviously this was, I was wrong.
Klausimas buvo, ar Žalgirio žaidėjai neturėjo pakankamą motivaciją šiandien. Tai yra derbis ir tikrai aš nors ir negaliu įlysti žaidėjom į galvas, tai motivacijos turėtų užtekti. Žinoma, visada lengva ieškoti pasiteisinimų, kad prieš porą dienų pralaimėjo Malbai, tačiau nesvarbu, Žalgiris turi laimėti kiekvienas rungtynes arba kautis iš visų jėgų. Atrodo, kad ne visi žaidėjai tą supranta. Norint įveikti rytą, reikia bent 10 žaidėjų indėlio. O anksčiau būdo per kai kurias LKL rungtynes, kad žaidėjai gaudavo polisą, o šiandien to negalėjo būti.
Coach Edgaras Lanas they played only 5 minutes. We saw him, he started like with 3 turnovers. Could you comment on him? What this guy is struggling with? And
who?
Edgar Aslanovas.
Ole.
Yeah, could you comment on him? What he is struggling?
Listen, also, I'm really supportive with him. Also, I talked before the game with him, you know, that I believe in him. He couldn't forget basketball. He's a very good player. I still believe in him. No matter what, it's beginning of the season. We just must help him, you know, all together. But you can see, I didn't expect that he will be, I will not say that bad, but you know that he will make such a bad decision in such a short time. And for this reason, you know, we decide to don't give him, you know, usually when we play LKL before, I give him a lot of chance to come to the rhythm. If you remember Cholet or the last game home, the last two games home, but obviously, I mean, he has some problems. We just need to help him to come out of this hole, you know, as soon as possible, because we need him.
Labai palaikau Edgarą Ulanovą, tikiu, kad jis gali žaisti geriau, tai yra tas pats krepšinis, dar tik sezono pradžia. Žinoma, šiandien nesitikėjau tiek prastų sprendimų per tokį trumpą laiką. Sakykime, anksčiau per kitas LKL rungtynes leisdavau jam įeiti ritmą, suteikdavau daugiau minučių, todėl turime ir toliau jo tikėti ir jam padėti išlipti iš šios duobės.
Coach, what were supposed to be the keys against switch all defense today? What was the plan to attack?
About their switching.
Yes, about their switching.
Yeah, okay. We didn't practice after the. We watch videos. We go walk through. You know, we talk about this. We have 2-3 systems. You know, but in the end of the day, it's reading. You know, if you miss this timing, you know, if you make bad decision, best passes. But again, I will. I will say, well, okay, we are not good on reading. Definitely, we are not good. You know, it's not a secret. But I will say that was problem was defense first half. You know, because we couldn't defend anything. You know, and after normally we couldn't develop our. You know, if you make 2-3 good defenses to make easy basket. You know, to go faster. You know. But we suffer, you know, they score everything and we make some bad calls, the players get nervous, some players get scared, you know, you can see immediately, you know, or they wait for another, we miss the timing and we get to the problems.
And how bad is our reporter?
Klausimas buvo apie varžovų keitimąsi gynyboje, kaip tam buvo ruoštasi, po praeitų rungtynių turėjome tik tai video peržiūrą. Apie tai kalbėjome, bet negalėjome treniruotėse to išbandyti, bet žinoma, pagrindinis dalykas yra situacijos skaitimas, kada veržtis, kada atiduoti perdavimą, o su situacijos skaitimu tikrai yra problemų pas mus. Kitas dalykas buvo mūsų gynimo pirmame kelinė, jeigu būtų pavykę apsiginti kelias takas, būtų gera emocija ir einant į polimą, o dabar kai kurie žaidėjai susinervino, kai kurie išsigando ir taip gavosi.
And coach, how badly Žalgiris suffers because of foul and bonus? Because pretty much every match we see the same players doing the same mistakes.
Excuse me?
About fouls and bonus, because every game we pretty much see the same players doing the same foul and bonus.
Foul and bonus?
Yes.
I don't know what to think about this. I mean, we are poor 1-on-1, you know, I mean, you mean they beat us too easy, you know, and after it's okay, for sure. Again, I will tell you this, it's tactically, you know, how what we talk about reading in offense, you know, about the switching is also reading. You must to see what's going on, you know, but still our 1-on-1 defense is terrible. Definitely we need to work a lot on this, you know. But still, it's team defense, we know this, we talk a lot of time about this, you know, that we are a slow team. This means we must really help each other. Five players defend the ball, you know, to have good hands, good rotation, good position. And, you know, one thing is in practice, one thing is in the game. And for sure, we need a lot of work to do to clear this.
Klausimas buvo apie pražangas bonuso situacijose. Tai treneris atsakė, kad tiesiog varžovai per lengvai mus įveikia vienas prieš vieną situaciją. Kaip kalbėjome apie skaitimą polime, taip ir reikia skaityti situacijas gynyboje. Žinoma, mūsų vienas prieš vieną gynyba tikrai yra prastoka, pakankamai lėta, todėl turime eiti į pagalbas ir treniruotėse tas sekasi geriau, bet reikia, kad ir rungtynėse tas įvyktų.
Coach, asking about the fans, they stopped you and all team after the game. Do you feel any pressure coming from their side?
Oh, God, we need pressure. You know, we need pressure. Good question. Definitely we deserve, you know, to be stopped. They show us support, but even if they don't show us support, you know, we definitely need to understand where we are and for who we play, and fans also show us this, you know.
Klausimas buvo apie spaudimą iš sirgalių. Tai mums reikia to spaudimo. Sirgaliai mus tikrai mums parodė palaikymą rungtynių, pasibaigus rungtynėms. Ir jie padeda suprasti, kas yra Žalgiris.
Are all those changes the Jaguars is making just for this season, or are you looking forward to the next season, you know, because you signed Ty Webster for one season, Zara neither, you fired Modie, so what is your opinion about that?
Look, it's not easy to find a player now on the market, you know. Also, you know, I mean, our budget, not really, but even that money is not important. It's not a lot of players who will come to be free, you know. And definitely, you know, when you decide to bring some players, you know, you want to bring something what we don't have. Zoran, I think, you know, he shows something today, you know. Ty still need time, and for sure this game didn't came in the right time, you know. It would be more easier if you play some weaker opponent in the league to give him more minutes, to risk more, you know. But how the game go today, you know, I couldn't find them more time.
Klausimas buvo apie pasitikimus komandą, tai šio sezono metu nėra lengva rasti žaidėjų rinkoje. Žinoma, ir mūsų biudžetas nėra toks didelis, tačiau net čia ne biudžeto klausimas, nes tiesiog nėra pakankamai žaidėjų, kurie tiktų šiuo metu Žalgiriui. Zoranas šiandien šiek tiek parodė savęs, tai dar reikia laiko ir šiandien nebuvo tos rungtynės, kada būtų galima eksperimentuoti.
Coach, when do you think the right time will come for Žalgiris? Do you have any deadline for victory? Like?
You think in Euroleague, huh? I mean,
or maybe against Rytas.
Okay, Rytas, we will wait for the next.
January,
yeah, next game. In Euroleague, we know every opponent. For us now is very, I mean, no secret, you know, it's really tough. We have what we have, we must work, you know, this is our job right now, you know, we are definitely not on the level, and also the confidence of the players is not great. I mean, it's obviously. But I hope soon, before, sorry, I hope soon, I mean.
Tikimės, kad pergalė bus greitų laikų. Žinome, Eurolygoje yra stiprus varžovai, tačiau turime dirbti, stengtis.
Let's say sometimes the wins come when you don't expect, you know. You know, when you expect to win, sometimes you lose, but yeah.
Kartais pergalės ateina tada, kai nesitikė, o kai tikės laimėt, kas jau pralaimė.
Coach, we know that you are a defensive-minded coach, but this team does not have lots of talent on defense, to put it mildly. So I'll be straight. Do you think it can work for you with this team?
Okay, look, as I say in the beginning, you know, I think every coach wants to play good defense and score a lot of points, you know. It's also, I mean, it's not secret. We work on defense, we work on offense. I mean, it's, we try to score points, we try to defend still. How we are now, you know, also offensively, we are not really talented, honestly. I mean, we are very one way, we have one way, one direction team, you know. We don't have a lot of tactical weapon. I mean, today I put Tyler on five in the end, you know, this is one, let's say, you know, but with three big guys, after you must, you know, this is the tactical weapon, how the game go to find different ways to attack. To especially when the defense start to adjust on you. And definitely, you know, it's for this reason I believe that if we will let opponent around 70 points, you know, we'll have a good chance to win. Or at least we will be, you know, close. This is how it is. I mean, end of the day, if you see the scores in EuroLeague, you know. And what I want to tell you, you know, to work on this 3-4 possession defensively, rebound defense, you know, normally offensively to score more. It's just 3-4 possessions, you know, this can be 10 points, but it's a lot, you know. Small, but a lot, and this how it is.
Kiekvienas treneris nori žaisti gerai gynyboje ir lengvai pelnyti taškus. Dirbama ties tuo treniruotėse. Žinoma, šioje komandoje mūsų žaidėjai yra gana panašus vienas į kitą, todėl sunku taktiškai kažką naujo padaryti. Pavyzdžiui, šiandien bandėme Tylerį 5 numeriu, kad praplėstų polimą. Jeigu praleistume 70 taškų, tai mūsų šansai laimėti ar būti rungtynėse iki pat pabaigos būtų daug didesni. O iki to reikia tiesiog 3-4 apsigintų atakų ir panašiai tiek užpultų 10 taškų daug ką keičia.
Can you expand a bit on that thought about the team being with one direction on offense?
We wait, I mean, definitely, you know, Lovern will give us, you know, I don't know what you mean, to bring some new players or to work with this team.
No, you mentioned that this team has only one direction on offense, and what do you mean by that?
This is mean that, you know, we have two fives, the same, you know, same style, you know, that they cannot play very good back to the basket there, you know, they cannot shoot mid-range, you know, this I mean, you know, we cannot tactically, you know, for this reason say we try to put Tyler on five to extend to he can shoot 3 points the paint, because we have some guys who can penetrate, also Ulanovic in the end of the day, you know, to help him something from him from low post, you know, you need to stretch the floor, you need five men to, you know, if you watch Alba or I don't know FS, how we lost, you know, the five men stretch the floor and the score, or 3-point and mid-range game, you know, this is, you know, this I want to say, we are one direction, you know, this have a lot of tactical weapons. And for this reason, normally, we need to play good defense, you know.
Klausimas buvo apie vienodos stilių žaidėjus. tai treneris sakė, kad tiesiog, aišku, kalbant apie vidurio polėjus, turime du žaidėjus, kurie yra gana panašaus stiliaus, mažai žaidžia nugarą į krepšį ar nemeta iš vidutinio nuotolio, todėl būtų gerai turėti žaidėją, kuris galėtų praplėsti polimą, kaip, pavyzdžiui, buvo Albos arba FS rungtynėse, kur varžovai tiesiog varžovų didelį žaidėjį pataikė iš vidutinio nuotolio.
So, coach, do I understand correctly? A new big guy, you think can solve Žalgiris at least some problems?
Excuse me?
A new big guy, a new center can solve Žalgiris at least some problems on this day?
For sure, I mean, it's obviously. But it's difficult to find the player, you know.
Naujas aukštaugis, žinoma, kad padėtų komandai, tačiau labai sunku rasti tokį žaidėją.